Today, we will discuss an interesting topic, mythology. The term mythology generally means the study of myths or a body of myths regarding a particular subject. The word mythology comes from ancient Greek word
mythologia,
which is a combination of two Greek words
mythos
and the suffix
logia.
Mythos means speech or narrative, and logia is a kind of study. And the overall meaning of the word mythologia is storytelling. Plato used mythologia as a general term for fiction or storytelling of any kind. The Greek term then borrowed into Latin and became
mythologie.
The Latin term was then adopted in Middle French as
mythologie
or
mythologie.
Then English adopted the word
mythology
in 15th century. Now, as I said, mythology is a study of myths. So, general question is, what is the meaning of myth? Definitions of myth to some extent vary by a scholar to scholar. Finnish folklorist Lauri Honko said,
"Myth, a story of the gods, a religious account of the beginning of the world, the creation, fundamental events, the exemplary deeds of the gods, as a result of which the world, nature, and culture were created together with all parts thereof, and given their order which still obtains. A myth expresses and confirms society's religious values and norms. It provides a pattern of behavior to be imitated, testifies to the efficacy of ritual, with its practical ends, and establishes the sanctity of cult."
Mythology tries to answer the most difficult and the most basic questions of human existence. According to poet Robert Graves,
"Myth has two main functions. The first is to answer the sort of awkward questions that children ask, such as who made the world? How will it end? Who was the first man? Where do souls go after death? The second function of myth is to justify an existing social system and account for traditional rites and customs."
Folklorist Alan Dundas defines myth as a sacred narrative that explains how the world and humanity evolved into their present form. Dundas classified a sacred narrative as
a story that serves to define the fundamental worldview of a culture by explaining aspects of the natural world and delineating the psychological and social practices and ideals of a society.
Anthropologist Bruce Lincoln defines myth as
ideology in narrative form.
The Christian theologian Conrad Hires wrote that
in a religious context, however, myths are storied vehicles of supreme truth, the most basic and important truths of all. By them, people regulate and interpret their lives and find worth and purpose in their existence. Myths put one in touch with sacred realities, the fundamental sources of being, power, and truth. They are seen not only as being the opposite of error, but also as being clearly distinguishable from stories told for entertainment and from the workaday, domestic, practical language of people. They provide answers to the mysteries of being and becoming, mysteries which, as mysteries, are hidden, yet mysteries which are revealed through story and ritual. Myths deal not only with truth but with ultimate truth.
According to Devdutt Patnaik,
myth is truth, which is subjective, intuitive, cultural, and grounded in faith.
To the ancient, the meaning of the story was most important, not the literal truth of the details of a certain version of a tale. In a broad sense, the word mythology can refer to any traditional story, or more precisely, we can say mythology is a collection of stories told to explain nature, history, and customs. According to psychiatrist Carl Jung,
myth is a necessary aspect of the human psyche, which needs to find meaning and order in a world which often presents itself as chaotic and meaningless.
Devdutt Patnaik says, from myths come beliefs, from mythology comes customs. Myth enhances thoughts and feelings. Mythology influences behaviors and communications. Thus, myth and mythology have a profound influence on culture. Similarly, culture has a profound influence on myth and mythology.